Good morning, my dear students. Myself, Dhaneswar, assistant professor in the Department of Chemistry at Arya Vidyapeeth College. Today's topic is chemical kinetics. In this chapter, I am going to discuss mainly about rate of the reaction, instantaneous rate, rate expression, and simple and complex reaction. Rate of a reaction mainly depend upon the concentration, temperature and pressure, etc. According to the law of mass action, rate of a reaction is proportional to the concentration of the reactant species. That is, higher the concentration of the reactant species, higher is the reaction rate. Rate of a reaction may be defined as the change in concentration of any one of the reactant or product per unit time. Mathematically, rate of a reaction is equal to change in concentration per unit time. If concentration of the reactant or product species is taken as mole per liter and time in second, in that case, unit of the reaction will be mole per liter per second. If concentration of the reactant or product is taken as mole per liter and time in minute, in that case, unit of the reaction will be mole per liter per minute. For a hypothetical chemical reaction, A plus B, it gives C plus D. Here, A and B are the reactant species and C and D are the product species. Here, stoichiometric coefficient of A is 1 and stoichiometric coefficient of B, C and D are also 1. In that case, rate of the reaction may be expressed as minus del A by del T is equal to minus del B by del T is equal to del C by del T is equal to del D by del T. Here, C and D are formed due to the consumption of reactant species A and B. Therefore, concentration of A and B reactant species gradually decreases with the passage of time. At the same time, concentration of C and D are gradually increases with the passage of time. Therefore, the change in concentration of A and B will be negative. Therefore, in the rate expression, there is a negative sign for reactant species, that is for A and B. For a general hypothetical chemical reaction, A of A plus B of B, it gives C of C plus D of D. Here, stoichiometric coefficient of reactant A is small a and stoichiometric coefficient of B is small b and stoichiometric coefficient of C is small c and stoichiometric coefficient of D is small d. In that case, rate of the reaction will be equal to minus 1 by small a into del A by del T is equal to minus 1 by small b into del B by del T is equal to 1 by small c into del C by del T is equal to 1 by small d into del D by del T. Here, del A by del T is equal to, is called rate of disappearance of reactant A, and del B by del T is equal to rate of disappearance of reactant B, and del B by del C is equal to rate of appearance of product C, and del D by del T is equal to rate of appearance of product D. Whenever A is means whenever del A by del T is divided by their stoichiometric coefficient, in that case it gives the rate of the reaction. Similarly, whenever minus del B by del T is divided by their stoichiometric coefficient, that is small b, in that case it gives the rate expression for the reaction. Next, instantaneous rate of the reaction. It is defined as the rate of change of any one of the reactant or product at that particular instant of time. For the reaction R gives P, the mathematically instantaneous rate may be represented as R instantaneous is equal to minus dr by dt is equal to plus dp by dt. Here del t tends to zero. Rate law or rate expression. Let us consider a general reaction. A of A plus B of B, it gives product species. Here, rate of the reaction may or may not be depend on all the concentration terms of small a of A and small b of B. Suppose, experimentally, rate of the reaction is found to depend upon alpha concentration terms of A and beta concentration terms of B. In that case, the rate of the reaction may be expressed as rate is directly proportional to the concentration terms of A power alpha into concentration terms of B power beta is equal to K concentration of A power alpha into concentration of B power beta. Equation 1 is called the rate law or rate equation or rate expression of the reaction, where K is the proportionality constant and it is called rate constant of the reaction. In equation 1, alpha is called the order of the reaction with respect to A and beta is called the order of the reaction with respect to B, and alpha plus beta is called the overall order of the reaction. Whenever we substitute concentration for A and B is equal to 1, in that case equation 1 is reduces to rate is equal to K, rate constant. Rate constant of a reaction at a given temperature may be defined as rate of the reaction when concentration of each of the reactants is unity. It is also called specific reaction rate. Characteristics of rate constants. Some important characteristics of rate constants are: rate constant is a measure of the rate of the reaction. Greater is the value of K, faster is the reaction rate. Different reactions have different values of rate constant. The value of rate constant of a reaction does not depend upon the concentration of the reactants. The value of rate constant for some reaction changes with temperature. The unit of rate constant depends upon the order of the reaction. Lastly, simple or elementary reaction. The reactions which taking place in one step are called elementary reaction. For example, decomposition of N2O5 is an simple or elementary reaction. Complex reaction. The reactions which take place through a sequence of two or more successive steps are called complex reactions. The detailed descriptions of various steps by which reactants changes into the product is called mechanism of the reaction. The reaction between hydrogen peroxide and ozone is an example of complex reaction. Though the reactions is seem to take place in one step, but it is a composed of three different consecutive steps. In the first steps, the decomposition of hydrogen peroxide, it gives H2O and O, and decomposition of ozone, it gives oxygen plus O, and finally combination of two atomic oxygen, it gives molecular oxygen, and addition of three consecutive reactions, it gives hydrogen peroxide plus ozone, it gives water and two molecular oxygen. These are my references, and thank you.